Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta and this is our fourth lecture on class 11 chapter 5 from Element Mathematics. We are going to questions 17 to onwards in this lecture. Firstly, I am going to take what we have to do in this lecture. We have to find out the square root of a complex number, which is very important for your examination point of view as well as for your competitive exams. So it will ask in the final exam as a long question. So it may be either for 4 marks, 5 marks, or 6 marks, according to dependent on your board exams. So please make a look how we can find out the square root of a complex number. Please make a first. If this is our 4, what is this 4? 4 is a real number. So if we want square root of 4, what's the result is 4, because I am giving example real number. If I am giving an example of real number and it wants to calculate its square root, and what's the square root of means again we get 2, and 2 is again your real number. It means if we want to find out square root of real number, the answer is your real number. Same here, if you find out square root of complex number, the answer will be again a complex number. So answer is again a complex number. We have to do the same. In this, what we have to do? Find the square root of 7 plus 24 iota, which is your complex number. So we have to find square root of 7 plus 24 iota. And we know, if we find out the square root, we will get a complex number. But we don't know the values of that complex number. So first we have to do, assume. I am assuming the square root of a complex number is x plus iota y. I am supposed. Now what you have to do? You have to do remove square root. And how we can remove the square root? By using squaring on both sides. Now do squaring on both sides. This is our first step. Step 1 is to consider the square root of a complex number is equal to x plus iota y. Now the second step is what? You have to take its squaring on both sides. So we have to do squaring on both sides. If we do squaring, then square root will be cancelled out and we will got 7 plus 24 iota. And here we will got square x plus iota y whole square, and we know what's the identity, a plus b whole square. Apply this 7 plus 24 iota as it is, a square plus b square plus 2ab. Easily applied. Now further solve. 7 plus 24 iota is equal to x square. Now what will be the values of iota square is negative 1. So it becomes negative y square plus 2xy iota. Now what we have to do? We have a symbol equal here. And whenever we find equal, we have to do equating. So I am solving here. Equating. What we have to equate? Real part is equate with real parts, and imaginary parts equate with imaginary part. Here what's the real part is 7. So 7, and what's the real part is here? X square and minus y square, because this term is iota connected, so it becomes an imaginary part. So 7 is x square minus y square, and imaginary part is what? 24, which is equal to 2xy. So we get two equations. This is your step 2. Now step 3, please keep it in mind. Step 3. Use formula. In this we have to use formula. What is formula? I am writing here x square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. You have to use this formula. X square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. So please keep it in mind, then I will rub this portion. Please make a note first. Now apply this formula. X square plus y square whole square is equal to what? X square minus y square is what? 7. And what is 2xy is equal to? 24. Now solve this. 7 square is 49, 24 is 576, which is equal to 625. Now we have to calculate only x square plus y square, then we have to do square root. So what's the values of x square plus y square is equal to? Square root of 625, which is equal to 25. It means we get x square plus y square is equal to 25. First equation is this and second equation is this. Now we have to solve these two equations. I am writing this equation 1 and this as an equation 2, and we have to solve it and find the values of x and y. So keep it in mind and note it, then I will rub this portion. We have to solve only x plus iota y. So please make a note. Now what we have to do? We have to solve this equation. First equation is what? 7 is equal to x square minus y square. And second equation is what? X square plus y square is equal to 25. And we have to solve. If we add them, the negative y square will be cancelled out with negative y square. So this will be cancelled out. We get 25 plus 7, which is 32, and x square plus x square we got 2x square. Now solve for the x. So we have to take the values of x square. We have to take 2 on the left hand side. We got what we will got? We get 16, which is equal to x square. Now what will be the values of x is? Plus minus 4. It means we get 2 values. X is plus 4 and y is negative 4. Now we have to also calculate the values of y. Now I am taking first is positive y, then I am take x is equal to negative 4. And how we calculate the values of y? By using equation this. I am taking this equation number 3. So using equation 3. Using equation 3. What's the equation? 2xy is equal to 24. 2xy is equal to 24. 2xy is equal to 24. We have to put the values. If I put x is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 into y is equal to 24. 2 into minus 4, minus 8. So what's the values of 24 minus 8, which is equal to minus 3? We get y is equal to minus 3. Same here, if I put x is equal to 4, so 2 into 4, y is equal to 24. What's the value is? 3. So we get x and y. What's the answer is our? Answer is what? X, z is equal to x plus iota y. I am writing here. Please make a note here. What's our answer is? z is equal to x plus iota y, and we get x. X is what? Two values, plus minus 4. I am writing as plus minus 4. Now keep it in mind. When I am taking x is equal to positive 4, x is equal to positive 4. Y is also positive. It means also positive. And iota is as it is. If we take x is equal to negative 4, what's the value is? Negative 3. It means again negative 3. So this can also be right as, if I take plus minus 4 common, this becomes 4 plus 3 iota. This one is your final answer. Please make a note. Now I am going to take second part, 5 minus 12 iota. Now do the same steps you have to do. Let square root of 5 minus 12 iota is equal to x plus iota y. Second step is what? Scaling on both sides. If we do scaling, what we will get? 5 minus 12 iota, which is equal to x plus iota y whole square. Now solve this. 5 minus 12 iota. Here we apply a plus b whole square. Solve this. A square plus b square plus 2ab. Now solve for the 5 minus 12 iota is equal to x square. And what's the value of iota square is? Negative 1. So it becomes negative y square plus 2xy iota. Now what's the real part is here? We have to do equating. Real part is equal to real part and imaginary part is equal to imaginary part. What's the real part is here? 5. And imaginary real part is here? X square minus y square. Equation 1. Now second equation, imaginary part is here what? Minus 12. And imaginary part is here? 2xy. Now third step is apply the formula. Now formula is what? X square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. Now put it well, x square minus y square is what? 5. So we have to put 5 square. And what is 2xy is what? Minus 12. Minus 12. If we solve, 5 square is 25 and minus 12 square is 144, which is equal to 169. And we have to find x square plus y square. So we have to do square root. So x, I am writing here, x square plus y square is equal to square root of 169, which is equal to 13. Now what we have to solve? We have to solve the values for x. Our first equation is what? X square minus y square is, this is equation 1. You can take this is equation 2 and this is equation 3. So from equation 1, x square minus y square is what? Is 5. Now second equation is what? X square plus y square is equal to 13. Now the signs are opposite, they have cancelled out. We got 2x square is equal to 13 plus 5, 18. Then x square is what? 9. Then what's the value of x is? Plus minus 3. Now we have to calculate y. First we have to take x is equal to plus 3. Then we have to take x is equal to negative 3. What's the equation? Equation number 2. Here 2xy is equal to minus 12. So please make a note first, then I will rub this portion. Now we have to solve. 2xy is equal to minus 2. First I am taking x is equal to 3. So 2 into 3 into y is equal to minus 12. So 2 into 3 is 6. If we divide by 6, we get minus 3. It means when x is 3, y is minus 3. Now we have to do for x is equal to minus 3 also. X is equal to minus 3, put it here. 2 into minus 3 into y is equal to minus 12. 2 into 3, minus 6, minus 12 divided by minus 6, minus minus 6 goes up 12. Sorry, here I am at 2. So we get 2. Now what is the value when I am taking x is minus 3, y is 2. And what's our answer is? Z is equal to x plus iota y. What's the value of x is? When x is 3, y is negative 3. When x is negative 3, y is positive. So we get this solution. You can write also by taking plus minus common. If you take plus minus 3, then it remains here. We will got y is equal to 2. If we take plus minus common, what we will get? 3. And if we take plus, then remains negative. It means we get answer negative. This is our final answer. Please make a note. Now our third part is minus 2 plus 2 square root 3 iota. Now do the same step. Minus 2 plus 2 square root 3 iota is equal to x plus iota y. Now what we have to do? Squaring on both sides. We get minus 2 plus 2 square root 3 iota is equal to x plus iota y whole square. So this is minus 2 plus 2 square root 3 iota, which is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now solve this. Minus 2 plus 2 square root 3 iota is equal to x square, and iota square is negative. Y square plus 2xy iota. Now we have to do equating. We get minus 2 is real part, and what's the real part is here? X square minus y square. This is equation 1. What's the imaginary part is here? 2xy is equal to 2 root 3. So if we cut them, 2 is equal to 2, we get xy is equal to root 3. This is equation 2. Now third step is formula. X square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. Now what's the value of x square minus y square is what? Minus 2. So we got minus 2 square. Now what's the value of 2xy is what? 2 root 3. So we get minus 2 square is 4, and 2 square is 4 into 3, 12. We get 16. Now we have to calculate x square plus y square. So what's the value of square root of 16? We get plus minus 4. Now we have to use for finding the values of x. X square plus y square is here 4. Because this term is square, we get only positive here. Now what's the equation is? X square minus y square is equal to negative 2. Now sign change, that will be cancel out. X square plus x square, which is equal to 2x square. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. 2 it cancel out with 2. X is equal to 1. So x is equal to plus minus 1. Now if I take x is equal to 1, then what will be the y? I am using this. Xy is equal to root 3. If x is equal to 1, then y is equal to root 3. If I take x is equal to negative 1, so negative 1 into y is equal to root 3. Y is equal to negative root 3. And what will our answer is? Z is equal to x plus iota y. And what is x? When I am taking x is positive 1, the answer y is corresponding to पॉजिटिव रूट से. When I'm taking x is negative, y is also negative, so we get here negative. So answer is plus minus 1 plus square root of 3 pi. This one is your final answer. Please make a note. So next part is to find out the square root of negative iota. We have to find out the square root of negative iota, and you know how to write a complex number is. When the real part is not specified, we have to take sign is 0. So 0 minus iota can be write minus iota. The same step is what? We have to take it x plus iota y. Now do scaling. We got minus iota is equal to x plus iota y whole square. This becomes minus iota is equal to x square plus iota square y square plus 2xy iota. Now solve this. Minus iota is equal to x square. Iota square is negative 1 minus y square plus 2xy iota. Now equating, real part is here 0. So 0 is equal to x square minus y square. Elimination part is here minus 1 and here is 2x. Y. So we have to use, if we solve this, what we will put? X square is equal to y square. X square is equal to y square. Now use the formula is what? X square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. Now what's the result? X square minus y square is what? 0. This means we get 0 ka square. And plus 2xy is equal to negative 1. It means we get negative 1 square. So this is 1. So we get x square plus y square is equal to 1. This is our second equation. Now we have to use our first equation is what? X square minus y square is equal to 0. And this equation is x square plus y square is equal to 1. Now this will be cancelled out. 2x square is equal to what? 1. So x square is equal to 1 upon v2. Then x is equal to plus minus 1 by square root of 2, because 1 square root is also 1. Now we have to find out what's that? 2xy is equal to minus 1. 2xy is equal to minus 1. Now first one is x is equal to 1 by root 2. What's the value? 2 into 1 by root 2 into y is equal to negative 1. Now you know 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2 into y upon by root 2 is equal to negative 1. Root 2 cancel out with root 2. And this root 2 take it on the right hand side. But we will put minus 1 by root 2. Same here. When I put x is equal to minus root 2, y is plus 1 by root 2. So our what's our answer is z is equal to x plus iota y. What is x? X is plus minus 1 upon me root 2. If I put x is positive but y is negative, it means the answer is negative positive 1 by root 2. If we take 1 by root 2 as is common, we got 1 minus iota. This one is your final answer. Please make up. Now our next question is find out the square root of this. This is not a number because we have to find out the square root of a complex number. Then how we can write it as minus 441 divided by 625 plus means 0 iota, because in this complex number imaginary part is 0. If we found out the square root of this, we have to take that which is equal to x plus iota y. If you do squaring, so please make a note here, because in this imaginary part is 0, then you will got another square root is also a negative. So how we can solve it? Please make a note here. If we solve it squaring, we got माइनस 441 डिवाइड बाय 625 व्हिच इज इक्वल टू हियर एक्स प्लस आयोटा वाई होल स्क्वायर. नाउ डू इट योर सेल्फ. नाउ व्हाट हैपन यू हैव टू डू फॉलो. इट्स अ लॉन्ग वे. यू कैन डू इट वेरी क्विकली. हाउ यू कैन डू इट क्विकली, प्लीज मेक अ नोट हियर. वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट alternating approach. We have to find out the square root of minus 441 divided by 625, and this can be written as, how can be written as, minus 41 can be replaced by iota square. So we can replace by iota square. This is 625, and 441 is square root of 21. This is iota and this is 25. So we get an answer of 25, which answer 0 plus 21 upon by 25 iota. If such a question is given in terms of this, you can do this approach and calculate fastest answer. This approach is length. You have to do this approach. Please make a note. Now our next question is, you have to find out the square of this complex number. Don't worry, this is looking very complex, but this answer is very short. First, you have to apply simplification. Then you have to do its square root. So, what's the LCM of this is? 5 minus 4 iota into 5 plus 4 iota. Now, to solve, 2 plus 3 iota multiplied with 5 plus 4 iota. Now, solve this. 2 minus 3 iota multiplied with 5 minus 4 iota. Now solve this. 2 into 5, 10. 2 into 4, 8 iota. 3 into 5, 15 iota. And 3 into 4, 12 iota square. Same here. 2 into 5, 10. 2 into 4, minus 8 iota. Minus 3 into 5, minus 15 iota. And minus minus plus 3 into 4, 12 iota square. Here a minus b, a plus b, we can write as a square minus b square. Now please, here is 8 iota is positive, but 8 iota is negative. 15 iota is positive, 15 iota is negative. But we will go 10 plus 10, which is equal to 20, plus 12 plus 12, 24 iota square, which is equal to 5 square is 25 minus 4 square is 16 iota square. Now solve. 20 plus 24 iota square is what? Negative 1. Same here. 25 minus 16 minus 1. We got 20 minus 24 divided by 25 plus 16. We get minus 4 upon 41. Now we have to do square root. Square root of minus 4 upon 41 can be written as same as we did first. 4 by 41 minus 1 can be represented by iota square. Now solve this. 4 square is 2 and root 41 as it is, and iota square is iota. So our final answer is 0 plus 2 square root 41 iota. This is our final answer. Please make a note. Now our next question number 20, the first part is, find the values of this when x is equal to 3 plus iota. Such question can be do with two approach. I am giving both the approach. Firstly, you have to do, you have the values of x, so you can put and you can solve. Now what is x is 3 plus iota. So we will solve 3 plus iota whole cube. Here minus 3. 3 plus iota whole square minus 8. 3 plus iota plus 15. Now solve this. A plus b whole cube. You know what's identity? A cube plus b cube. I am writing a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. I am here applying identity a plus b whole square. ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए बी. नाउ आई मल्टीप्लाई माइनस एट इंटू थ्री वी गॉट माइनस 24, माइनस एट इंटू आयोटा वी गॉट माइनस एट आयोटा प्लस 15. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. 3 क्यूब इज 27 एंड व्हाट्स द वैल्यू ऑफ आयोटा क्यूब इज माइनस आयोटा प्लस 3 इंटू 3 9 आयोटा 9 आयोटा इंटू 3 27 आयोटा 9 आयोटा इंटू आयोटा वी गेट 9 आयोटा स्क्वेयर. नाउ माइनस 3 3 स्क्वेयर इज 9 एंड आयोटा स्क्वेयर इज नेगेटिव 1 प्लस 2 इंटू 3 6 आयोटा माइनस 24 एंड प्लस 15 माइनस 24 प्लस 15 वी गॉट माइनस 9 माइनस 8 आयोटा. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. 27 माइनस आयोटा प्लस 27 आयोटा प्लस 9 आयोटा स्क्वायर इज नेगेटिव 1. नाउ डू मल्ट अगेन सॉल्व. 9 माइनस 1 8 प्लस 6 आयोटा माइनस 9 माइनस 8 आयोटा. 27 माइनस आयोटा प्लस 27 आयोटा माइनस 9. नाउ डू मल्टीप्लाई माइनस 3 इंटू 8 माइनस 24 माइनस 6 इंटू 3 18 आयोटा माइनस 9 माइनस 8 आयोटा. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. रियल पार्ट इज व्हाट 27 9 24 एंड 9 एंड व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्ट इफ वी सॉल्व देम. व्हाट वी विल गेट 27 एंड दिस इज माइनस 9 एंड माइनस 9 माइनस 18 18 एंड 4 22 एंड 22 और 20 इज 42. नाउ सॉल्व दिस. 27 आयोटा पॉजिटिव एंड दिस इज 20 18 प्लस 8 26 एंड 127 इट मींस वी गेट सॉरी प्लीज मेक अ नोट हियर व्हाट्स द रिजल्ट इज 27 माइनस प्लीज जस्ट वेट अ मिनट सो आवर करेक्ट कैलकुलेशन इज करेक्ट. नाउ 27 एंड दिस इज माइनस 9 माइनस 9 माइनस 18 एंड माइनस 18 एंड माइनस 24 माइनस 42. नाउ माइनस आयोटा माइनस 19 आयोटा एंड 8 माइनस 27 आयोटा एंड दिस वन इज 27 आयोटा सो दिस आर कैंसिल आउट. 27 माइनस विच इज माइनस 15 दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर. प्लीज मेक अ नोट यू कैन डू इट इन अनदर अप्रोच. So our next approach, what we have to do, we have to find that when x is equal to 3 plus iota. So you have to solve this and make a equation in terms of which is equal to 0 and divide this and what's the remainder is your final answer. What you have to do? First you have to solve this. If I take x minus 3 is equal to iota, now squaring on both side, x minus 3 whole square is equal to iota square. This one is a square plus b square minus 2ab which is equal to minus 1. Now if we solve this x square minus 6x plus 9 and minus 1 becomes here 0. So this becomes x square minus 6x plus 10 is equal to 0. Firstly we have to make our equation, then we have to divide and the remainder is your final answer. Our equation is what? X cube minus 3x square minus 8x plus 15. Now we have to divide it from x square minus 6x plus 10. What we have to multiply it with? X. X into x square, we get x cube. X into minus 6, minus 6x square plus 10x. Now solve this. Negative, positive, negative. These cancel out. This becomes plus 3x square. And this becomes minus 18x plus 15. Now what we have to do? We have to do multiply it with 3. 3 into x square we get 3x square minus 18x plus 30. So if we change negative, positive, negative, this cancel out, these cancel out, and this becomes minus 15, which is your final answer. This is the second approach. You can also follow that approach to calculate when find the values when x is equal to given. Please make a note. So our second part is same. You can do both the approach, but the second approach is very easy to solve this question, because in first approach we have to know about the each identity, and it becomes very complex if you write wrong identity. But this method is very easy, so I am going to solve this method, but you can do same method also. First we have to take x is equal to 2 plus negative is replaced by iota square, so x is equal to 2 plus under root 3 iota. We have to solve. First we have to take minus 2 on the side, we get root 3 iota. Squaring, we got x minus 2 whole square is equal to 3 iota square. Apply a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab, which is 3 iota square is negative 1. So x square minus 4x plus 4, and if we take it minus, we get plus 3 square to 0. So we get x square minus 4x plus 7 is equal to 0. Now we have to divide it. X square minus 4x plus 7 we have to divide by x4 minus 4x cube plus 8x plus 35. What we have to do? Firstly, we have to do multiply. What we have to do? X square. Now multiply x square into x square, x4 minus 4x cube plus 7x square. Now solve this. This is negative, this is positive, this is negative. These cancel out, these cancel out, and this is x square, but this is x. So these are not cancel out, subtract. So we get minus 7x square plus 8x plus 35. Now what we have to do? We have to do multiply with minus 7. Minus 7 into x square, minus 7x square, minus 7 into 4, minus 28x. Now minus 7 into 7, minus 49. Now solve it. What's the result? This is positive, this is positive, this is positive. Then these are will be cancelled out. Please do it yourself. Let's make a note. We write something wrong here, x square, and we write x cube. So this is wrong. I am making the correction. Please make a note. Our term is x square minus 4x plus 7. We have to divide it from x4 minus 4x square plus 8x plus 35. Firstly, we have to do multiply with x square. X square into x square, x4 minus 4x cube plus 7x square. So that's why, firstly, I am writing the complete procedure. In this, a term is missing. So we have to write in place of that 0. X4 minus 4 plus 0x cube minus 4x square plus 8x plus 35. Now we have to multiply x square into x square, we got x4. X square into minus 4, minus 4x cube plus 7x square, we got negative, positive, negative. This cancel out, and this becomes positive 4x cube, and this becomes negative 11x square plus 8x plus 35. Now what we have to do? Now we have to do multiply it with 4x. 4x into x square, we got 4x cube. 4x into minus, minus 16x square plus 7 4s are 28x. Now this is negative, this is positive, this is negative. These are cancelled out. And 16 minus 11, we got 5x square. And this becomes minus 20x plus 35. Now we have to do multiply it with 5. 5 into x square, we got 5x square. 5 into minus, minus 20x. 5 into 7, 35. It means negative, positive, negative, all terms are cancelled. So our answer is 0. Please make a note. So some questions we left. So question number is 19. Question number 20 has third part. You have to do it yourself. I am taking up question number 19. But the question is prove that this is equal to 6. Please make a look. These sums are similar. So we have to take some assume. Firstly, we have to write in proper format 4 plus 3. Minus 20 can be written as 20 iota square. Same here, 4 minus 3, it can be written as 20 iota square, whole power 1 by 2. I am taking left hand sides. So 4 plus 3 root 20 and iota square come out, becomes iota 1 by 2. And same here, root 20 and iota comes out, becomes 1 by 2. I am taking, let's suppose that this sum is a x plus iota y, 4 plus 3 root 20 iota, I am considering it as x plus iota y. Now the terms are same, but the sign is opposite. So this becomes x minus iota y is equal to 4 minus 3 root 20 iota. The same power, we have to take power also, 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. Now what we have to solve? We have to find out the values of addition. It means we have to do add. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Again, please read. In this, we have to calculate the sum of this power. I am considering it as x plus iota y, and this term is considered as x minus iota y. And we have to find the sum of these terms. So in this, we have doing additions of equation 1 and 2. Add equations 1 and 2. Now x plus x becomes 2x, and iota y minus iota y cancel out each other. We will get 4 plus 3 square root 20 iota whole power 1 by 2 plus 4 minus 3 square root 20 iota whole power 1 by 2. Now I am solving this and taking squaring on both sides. It becomes 4x square. This is your a and this is your b. If we take all square, a square plus b square plus make 2ab. So firstly I am writing here 4, 3, 2, 20 iota whole power 1 by 2 plus 4 minus 3 square root of 20 iota whole power 1 by 2. Because I am doing scaling, this square is 4x square and this square is 2. Now applying a plus b whole square. Now what's the whole square is? 1 by 2 can be written in terms of square root. So I am replacing it by square root. So solve this. A square plus 2ab. A is what? 4 plus 3 root 20 iota into b. Because both are in roots, so we can take a single root. 4 minus 3 square root 20 iota. Now we have to solve it. So please make a note, then I will rub the upper portion. So please make a note, we have to prove this term is equal to 6. So I am rubbing this portion. Now solve this. This is 4x square, and we know if we do square, then square root will be cancelled out. We get 4 plus 3 root 20 iota. Same here, we get 4 minus 3 root 20 iota plus 2. Please make a look. A plus b. A minus b. Again, a square minus b square. So we are doing a square minus b square. This is equal to 4x square, which is equal to, this term will be cancelled out, positive and negative. 4 plus 4 becomes 8 plus 2 square root. 4 square is 16 minus 3 square is 9, 9 into 20, 180 iota square. So 4x square is equal to 8 plus 2 under root 16 minus 180 into minus 1. We got 4x square is equal to 8 plus 2 under root 16 plus 180, which is equal to 196. And what's the square root of 196 is 14. So I am solving here. This becomes 4x square is equal to 8 plus 14 into 2, 28. 4x square is equal to 36. X square is equal to 9, and x becomes plus minus 3. So we get x is equal to 3. Now please take our first quiz. What's the result is? I am solving here. What's our result is? I am using this concept. This is our equation 1. What we have to do? Our question 4 plus 3 root 20 iota 1 by 2, which is equal to what? 2 into x. And we get the value of x. X is what? 3. So we get 6. And this is the our term that we have to prove. 4 plus 3 square root 20 iota, this term is equal to 6. Hence, prove. So, before, whenever you got this term, you have to take it equation 1 and put the values of x in this equation, and you get the desired equation. That is, you have to prove. So, please make a note. So we did this one question more. Question number is 17. Prove that Z1, Z2 belongs to a complex number. C belongs to complex number. Then you have to verify two parts. First part is this and second part is this. RA stands for basically real part and IM stands for imaginary part. In this you have to take two complex number. You have to do assume that I am doing first part. Let Z1 is x1 plus iota y1 and z2 is x2 plus iota y2. Now we have to find out first our left hand side is what? Real parts of z1 into z2. It means we have to do multiply. Solve this. Real part z1. Z1 is what? X1 plus में iota y1 and z2 is what? X2 plus में iota y2. Now you have to do multiply. X1 into x2, x1 x2 plus x1 into y2 iota plus iota means x2 y1 iota plus y1 y2 iota square. Now solve this. X1 into X2 plus, if I take iota as a common, I get X1 Y2 plus X2 Y1. Here iota square is negative 1, so it becomes minus Y1 into Y2 because iota square is negative 1. So it indicates RE means real parts. In this case question, what's the real part is what? X1 X2 minus Y1 Y2. Okay, solve further. X1 x2 and real part is here minus y1 y2, and what this is, what this is your imaginary part. So our answer is what? Our real part is what? Is x1 x2 minus y1 y2. This is our left hand side. Now we have to do solve right hand side. This is our right hand side. Please make a note first, then I will drop. Please make a note. Our answer is x1 x2 minus y1 y2. You have to note it. Now we have to apply it. This is our left hand side. I write here, and our right hand side is this. I am writing here. Now solve the same concept. What is real part of z1? Z1 is what? X1 plus me iota y1 into real part of z2. Z2 is what? एक्स टू प्लस में आयोटा वाई टू माइनस इमेजिनरी पार्ट ऑफ जेड वन, जेड वन इज अगेन एक्स वन प्लस में आयोटा वाई वन इंटू इमेजिनरी पार्ट जेड टू, जेड टू इज वॉट एक्स टू प्लस में आयोटा वाई टू। नाउ वट इज रियल पार्ट इज इन दिस केस एक्स वन, सो वी गो एक्स वन। वट्स द रियल पार्ट इन दिस केस एक्स टू, वी गो एक्स टू। माइनस इमेजिनरी पार्ट इज वॉट, बिकॉज आयोटा इज कनेक्टेड विद वाई वन, सो वी गेट वाई वन। एन इमेजिनरी पार्ट इज वाई टू, सो वी गेट वाई टू। सो दिस इज आवर राइट हैंड साइड। नाउ प्लीज मेक अ कंपेरिजन, दिस इज योर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, दिस इज योर राइट हैंड साइड। सो फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन एंड दिस टू, फ्रॉम वन एंड टू, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड। We have to do this. We have to do same in the second part. I hope you like my video. If you really like my video, so don't forget to subscribe my channel, Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes, and press the button of like, and don't forget to subscribe as well as to share it with your friends, so that everyone which are reading from the NCERT as well as Element Mathematics will do the remaining questions as for your practice purpose also. So we will meet very soon. We'll take our next exercise 5.3 very soon. So for watching my video from start to end, I really thank you.